Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to talk about what an open loop control system is and give a few examples to ensure you understand. An open loop control system means that the input of the control system is not dependent on the output of the control system. This means that our system cannot adjust itself based on some condition. We trigger some event and the system will operate for a given amount of time. Let's draw a block diagram of an open loop control system so we know what we're working with. So, what does this block diagram mean? Well, with an open loop control system, we cannot adjust the input based on the output like we could with a closed loop control system, which we will talk about in the next video. Let's think of a few examples to ensure that we understand. Let's think of a dishwasher. We turn the dishwasher on and it will produce the same result every single time. This is a great example of an open loop system. We adjust the timer setting on the dishwasher and it will operate for a given amount of time. The control system does not depend or adjust the dishwasher runtime based on how clean the dishes are. Therefore, the output does not affect the input at all. Another example could be your toaster timer or the laundry machine. Therefore, in all the control systems, the output has no effect on the input. Although open loop controls are the easiest to implement as they only require a single input and time, they're not applicable in most scenarios in which a control system is needed. Let's think of our shower's temperature. Obviously, a simple push-button start would not work as we want to allow each individual that uses the shower to select how warm they want the water and how long the water runs for. So, in summary, an open-loop control system is when the input is not affected by the output of the control system. In general, open-loop controls are simple, cheaper, and amazing in some scenarios. However, their applicability is limited. Thank you for checking out the video. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.